In this series, we'll take a look at how to import an image so that you can draw on top of it. This is really good if you're trying to draw over a sketch or maybe a floor plan that you received as a JPEG or PDF, and that way you can draw on top of it using it as a reference. To get started here, let's go to File Import. Let's make sure our format is set up to all supported image types. And let's make sure we're using it as an image, not as a texture or used as new match photo. And the image that we're taking a look at is this floor plan image here. And the tip that you want to do here is know a distance in the image itself. So in this case, the dimension's here, so I know that this dimension here is 21 foot 4. You could also try to measure, let's say, you know, what the width of a doorway is, but it's not going to be as accurate. It's always better to use the longest distance possible. So we'll click import. That's a good habit. I always like to start importing from the origin point. So I'll click and release. I'll move my cursor to the right. And actually, if I knew the width of the paper and did the scale factor for it, you could actually type in the dimension here, or the width if you knew it. But in our case, let's just click just to sort of get the image in the model space. When you import as an image, it's similar to importing a surface, putting a texture on it, and then grouping it. So kind of think of an image in that case, in that it's an image that you can't sort of open, and it's sort of grouped or isolated. I should say it's sort of like locked. Think of it like a locked group. So it's great to just kind of trace on top of. If we want to actually draw inside and sort of cut away part of the image, we can right click and actually explode the image. That way it's an actually surface that we can draw on top of and then push pull. The only downside to this is it's a projected surface, so the sides sort of pull up, which actually in our case might actually help us a little bit. So I'm going to undo that. So we have the image imported. And the next thing I want to do is take the tape measure tool. And I don't want to draw a guide. So I want to turn off the plus sign on that tool there. In this case, I can press Option on a Mac, Control on a PC. And I'm going to scroll in as close as I can. And I'm going to click and release on the top of this distance. I'm going to scroll out. And scroll back down. And then I'm going to simply measure this. So I'm going to click again. SketchUp's telling me that my distance is a little over 42 feet, which is incorrect. I want it to be 21 foot sign 4, which I'll type into the keyboard. And then I'll press Enter. By pressing Enter, SketchUp's going to ask us to resize the model. And it's going to scale everything based off of that measurement. So there, I can click yes, and it looks like the model disappears. It's not that it's gone. It's just that it went lower down onto the screen because of the scale. So we can click the zoom tool here, zoom extents, to see that better. So now if we take the tape measure again, we can measure this distance and see we're pretty close to that 21 foot 4. And even over here, we can measure this 17 feet 8. And yeah, we're pretty close. So if you're doing a conceptual model where the precision and accuracy isn't important, so you know, if it's just about modeling up the walls and getting it close, then you could draw right on top of this. It doesn't matter. If you're looking to use this as a base and create more accurate measurements, now the next step that you can do is go in and actually create guides at those specific distances. Once this image is here, we can save it, and then we can move on to the next step. For more videos in this series, as well as live and online SketchUp training, visit SketchUpTrainer.com. You can also subscribe to this YouTube channel, as well as follow me on Twitter.